class is one of the biggest record executives of all time. We are so happy to welcome him back. Please welcome the legendary music producer, L.A. Reid.
And we are very festive.
Yeah, I could tell.
And excited to have you.
I'm happy to be here.
Okay, so
how's everything?
So amazing. I'm gonna jump right in.
Okay.
One of the biggest questions people have is obviously in a town like Los Angeles, there's so much talent. What does it take to take someone from just being a talented person to stardom?
Listen, I think it's their journey, first of all. We follow that light.
Yeah.
You know, we're not the magic, we don't have the magic button like people think. So it's really on the artist, right, to really have that commitment, that dedication, and just a little bit of magic.
Is there ever that one thing that you've seen in somebody? I mean, obviously you've discussed so many people from Avril Lavigne, Pink, and so many more.
Yeah.
That, is there a common thread ever?
I don't know, I think the common thread is lovability. The ability for people to love them as people.
Yeah.
And the music matters, right?
Yeah.
But I think it's the person first and foremost.
That's dope.
That's what I'm looking for.
Yeah. Like.
You know, you have done so many things for music, but what is your greatest career achievement personally for you?
That's such a tough question, and for the sake of my mental health, I'm not answering.
No! I read your book and there's so much in there.
I should have asked you the other question.
I know.
No, I'm proud. I'm so proud of so many artists, right?
Right.
Yeah. And I could name them, and I don't even want to be name dropping like that, right?
But I'm saying, like, personally, for you, I know you do a lot of artists, but where you come from, I read your book. It's like, it has to be a major achievement that you had to say, yeah, I did that.
Okay. Then it was the first time I ever heard a song that I worked on the radio.
Yeah, that's big.
The very first
time. What
was
the song?
It was a song called Body Talk.
Oh. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. It was by The Deal, right?
Yeah.
And it was the first time I heard myself on the radio, and I was like, okay, that felt great.
That's huge. That's
phenomenal.
A moment you'll never forget, for
never forget,
for sure.
That.
Yeah, absolutely.
One of the biggest things that we're seeing, obviously, is with all these new artists, is them actually going independent and not signing to a label. Mm-hmm. Now, you obviously have been a record executive for a very long time.
Right.
What do you think about that? And do you think that that's going to change the way music is made going forward?
Mm. Well, you know, we're in an interesting time, and there's room for both, right? Independent artists, that if they have what it takes to go independent, if they have that ingenuity to pull that off, which really means they don't require much help, right? Mm-hmm. But that's not for everybody.
Yeah.
Some people need to be in a major label system where they have a lot of, you know, hand-holding going on. And so I think it's, you know, to each his own, you know. But I think that it's always existed, you know. I'm an independent record executive now, but I've also been a major label record executive.
Yeah, you've done both. Yeah, what's the biggest difference?
I don't know. I consider myself like an independent major.
I see that.
Right.
You think independently, but you work in this.
Yeah, I can see that.
Yeah.
I don't think there's a better, like, for the artist I work on today, I think I probably work much closer with them now than I did when I had like a roster of 100 acts.
Mm. Yeah.
Yeah.
So it makes a huge difference. I think old school, the way that they used to groom artists was so different, and you were part of that thing.
Yes. And I still believe in that.
I really
believe in that.
It makes
like
a huge
everything.
Difference.
I'll bet, especially when somebody's new. I have to ask you, so Britney Spears recently got freed from her conservatorship.
Mm. Congratulations, Britney.
Yes, absolutely, well deserved. If she came to you, would you sign her right now?
Uh-oh.
Is that a trick question? Is she here?
It's not a trick
question. Is Britney here?
She's walking out. Britney,
she's here.
Come
on out.
Come on out, girl.
Yes.
What do you think?
I love her, you know, and I don't know if it would come to that, but if it did, I would have to strongly consider it because I really love Britney.
Oh, that's beautiful.
And it's not just that. If I'm being honest, I really live for the longevity of artists.
Yes.
And I like to give artists a home.
Yeah.
Right? So it's not always, okay, do I think I can have the biggest hit in the world with Britney?
Yeah.
It's more that every artist deserves to be taken care of, and I kind of live for that.
With that said, you know, there are a lot of artists that are redoing their first album. How do you feel about that?
I absolutely love that. I didn't think it would work.
Uh-huh.
Taylor Swift is doing it, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
And Ashanti.
I absolutely love it, and Ashanti is doing it.
Yes.
And
a lot of
I absolutely love it.
Really?
Yes. It's time for people to beat the system a little bit.
Exactly.
Right?
Oh, that's what I'm saying.
It's so great to hear from someone like you.
Yeah. Outsmart them. Yeah. Why not?
And you know, since the pandemic, we've had these versus battles. And how do you feel about those?
First of all, I love them. I think Swiss Beats and Timbaland are genius for creating it.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I've watched many of them.
Which one? Yeah. Who, if you had your perfect versus battle, who would you pick?
It's hard.
I know, it's hard.
I know.
Because we just had Shaka and Stephanie Mills.
Yes.
You know, I'm old school. The deal will go against who?
The Time.
Ooh, that's a good one.
That's a good one. But wait a minute, that's not my ideal one.
Okay.
But I'd be there for that.
What's your ideal one?
My ideal one, too. Okay. You really want this?
Yeah. Okay. Yes.
It's Mariah Carey versus Beyonce.
Ooh.
Bring that on.
You gonna hurt somebody.
Oh, my God. That would be the biggest one ever.
Come on, man.
And the fans that they both have.
And the hits they have,
the
legacy
hits,
that they have. And,
oh, that would be amazing.
And the range, and so much more.
B is the queen, right? We know B is the queen, right? Sometimes Mariah might be slightly underrated for how long her career has lasted, how many hits she has, and she practically owns Christmas.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
No, she does.
When it comes
she is the queen of Christmas.
So, I don't know. I think that would be a good
one. That's good.
Is that a good one?
That's a good one.
That's a real good one.
Because if we're being honest, when you think of Beyonce, no, you're like, who do you put up against Beyonce? It has to be an icon.
It has to be. That's the one.
Yeah. You're right. All right, speaking of somebody else that we are super excited to become an icon is your new artist, Ayiana-Lee, that you signed.
Yes.
Super excited about her. What was so special about her that caught your eye?
Yeah.
Everything that I love in talent. Mm-hmm. A little bit weird, and I don't mean that in a negative way.
No, it's good.
A little odd, an unusual voice, but stage commanding, you know, presence. The songs, everything about her, like, it really touched me.
Oh,
that's a lot exciting.
I know, I'm excited.
I cannot wait. Okay,
By the way, it took me 5 years to find this girl.
Really?
Really?
So you were on the hunt looking for new talent.
Yeah.
Like you always are.
Yeah, and I found some incredible artists that I love, right? Uh-huh. But this kind of talent kind of speaks to my career.
Yeah.
You know, she's sort of... Those artists you mentioned earlier, she's kind of like one of those.
Yeah, we were talking about, it's funny because I just told him, I'm like, everybody you've ever discovered, I didn't want to say it, but was a little weird. Or the audience would consider slightly left, a little like something different.
That's what makes somebody a star though,
that's
too, right?
That's what makes
Absolutely. You don't want to be
exactly.
common.